Welcome to Algebra 1, Unit 1, Day 1, Measures of Central Tendency. Objectives. I will be able to identify and use the mean, median, mode, and range. I will be able to analyze descriptive statistics to determine the implications for the real-world situations from which the data derive. Let's begin by looking at Situation 1. A student takes 8 tests in a quarter with the scores 92, 78, 90, 89, 48, 80, 48, and 98. Since the teacher uses the mean to find the grade, the student is only earning a 78. How would the student's grade change if he earned an 80 and 85 on the next 2 tests? If the teacher used the median to calculate the grade, how would that affect the grade? In order to answer these questions, we're going to need to examine some vocabulary. So let's start with that. Statistics. That's the study of the collection, analysis, interpretation, presentation, and organization of data. A statistic is one of the measurements describing the data. The ones that we're looking at today are the mean, median, mode, and range. But there are others. The measures of central tendency are the mean, median, and mode. These are used to describe a set of data by identifying the central position within that set of data. Notice the word central. That sounds like center. So it's kind of like finding the center or a middle type of position. When we think of central or center, we might think of middle. So that's similar. An observation is just one of the values in the set. The data are all the numbers in the set. So for example, looking back at our test scores, this is all of the data that we have gathered, versus if we just look at the first test score, the 92, for example, that is just one observation. The test score of 78 is another observation, and together it makes up the data. Using situation 1 from above, calculate the following measures of central tendency and the range. So we'll notice that there are 2 sets of data here. The first set was the original list of 8 tests. Then there's the set that includes the 2 new tests. So when we calculate the mean, which is another word for the average, this is one indication of the mathematical center. When we calculate the mean, we're going to first do it for the first set, and then do it for the second set that includes the 2 data points. Since the question asks how would the student's grade change, we need to examine both sets. So let's begin with the first set and calculate the mean. Remember that the mean, or the average, is when we add all of the observations and divide by how many there are. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 observations in my data set. So after I add those together, I'll divide by those 8. I'll divide by 8. I get exactly 77.875, but we're going to tend to round to 1 decimal place. So I'll say that approximately equals 77.9. And that is the mean, approximately, for the first set. Then we'll calculate the median. The median is the middle value of the data when arranged numerically. Remember that numerically means lowest to highest. So let's take the first set and arrange that numerically. Which one is the lowest in here? I see a 48 and another 48. So 48 and then 48. After those come 78 and then 80. And then 89, 90. And then 92 and 98. Notice I put marks by them so I remember that I've already included those observations. Now I want to see what is the middle value of the data. So this is one on each side, and then the second on each side, third on each side, fourth on each side, and the number in the middle. Well, there is no middle because there are eight. So I'm going to take the two that are in the middle and we average those or find the mean. So we'll do 80 plus 89 divide by 2 because there are two of those, and that gives us 84.5. That is the median of that first set of data. The mode is the value or values that occur the most. Mode, most. In the first set of data, what I see occurring the most is 48. I have two 48s. I have one of every other observation. So the mode is 48 in the first set of data. The range is the largest value minus the smallest value in the list. So it's helpful if we go back and look at the set in order. So I can see that the lowest is 48, the highest is 98. So when I calculate the range for the first set, it will be 98 minus 48, the highest value minus the lowest value, or the largest minus the smallest, and that will be equal 50. 50 is the range of the first set of data. Now we go back and try to answer the questions. How would the student's grade change if he earned an 80 and an 85 on the next two tests? So to be able to answer that question, we also have to look at the second set of data. So remember that those original eight tests gave us our first set of data. With the two extra tests, we combine it with that first set to make our second set of data. So it's all of these observations, 92, 78, 90, 89, 48, 80, 48, 98, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then two more, 80 and 85. And we can find the mean for the second set of data. Let's practice using the calculator to find these measures of central tendency and the range. Going to the calculator, we're going to press the STAT button, and then we're going to edit our list. Notice the calculator instructions that help remind you what to press. STAT 1 to edit, and entering the values into list 1. We could also press enter when it's highlighted on edit. If I already have numbers in the list, I can go up to the top of the list where it says L1 or list 1, press clear, enter, and now my list is clear. Now I can enter this data set. So let's do that. 92, enter. 78, enter. 90, enter. Notice that on each entry, it tells me which one I am on. So this is the first entry, second entry, third entry. I'm on the fourth entry where it's highlighted, and see it has a 4 there. So after I press 89, enter, it goes down to the fifth entry. So let's finish entering all of this list. Now I have my 10 entries there from my 10 tests. So now I press Stat, but this time I arrow over to the right like it shows me in the shortcut keys, and I choose number 1 for 1 variable statistics. I'm using list 1, so I can press Enter. And I'm going to just go down to the calculate command and then press enter. And it gives me a lot of the statistics from this data. X bar is another way to write what the mean is, and that says 78.8. Since we typically round to one decimal place, we'll just use what it says, and we don't have to worry about rounding. So we can write 78.8. for the mean in the second set. And remember, X bar is another way to write the mean. Let's write that up here by where it says mean. X bar. That's what our calculator shows us when we want the mean. For the median of the second set, let's take a look at how the calculator shows that. I'm going to scroll down a little bit, and there I see MED. That's the median, 82.5. So 82.5 is the median of the second set. Notice that the mean went from 77.9 up to 78.8 when we included two more tests. The median, on the other hand, went down from 84.5 to 82.5. So even though these are both measures of central tendency, they can give us different types of information. They're different types of centers. The calculator does not show us the mode. The mode for the second set, we'll have to figure out on our own. So looking at this list with the 80 and the 85, we have the 48 occurring twice, and now we also have the 80 occurring twice. So that means we have two modes in the second set. 48 is a mode, and 80 is a mode, because they both occur the most. The range for the second set, well, the highest number is still 98, and the lowest number is still 48. That didn't change because we didn't add lower or higher numbers. So the range will not change, 98 minus 48, which is still 50. An outlier is an observation point that is distant from other observations. Notice in situation number 2, there are some outliers. The ages of the people in Mrs. Robbins' preschool classroom are the following. 3, 4, 3, 4, lots of 3s, 4s, and 5s because it is a preschool class, little kids. Then we've got 78 and 59. These are outliers because they are distant from the main group of observations. A lot of the observations are around 3, 4, and 5, and these are very far away. A, which measure of central tendency best describes the age in this classroom? Explain. So remember, our measures of central tendency are the mean or x bar, if we're looking at it on the calculator, the median, or MED, if we're looking at it on the calculator, and the mode, which just by looking at the list, we can easily see that 4 happens the most. So the mode here equals 4. The mean and the median, let's practice using the calculator or another form to find those measures of central tendency. After entering the data in the list, we press Stat, go over to Calc, and choice number 1. And then using list 1, we press Enter to calculate, and it shows us X bar, the mean is 11.5. And because I'm rounding, I'm going to write that it's approximately 11.5. And the median, scrolling down to see the median, equals exactly 4. So that equals 4. So which of these three measures best describes the age in this classroom? Well, it's a preschool class. So is there anybody that's going to be around 11 or 12 years old? No. So the median, which says 4, or the mode, which says 4, would be the best measures of central tendency to use for this class. So we'll say the median or the mode. Why? How do we explain? Well, this is a preschool class. In a preschool class, nobody would be 12 years old. That just wouldn't make sense. Part B, explain why the mean is not always a good description of a number set. Well, how did we get a mean of 11.5? We had outliers. We had numbers that skewed the mean. So we can say that the mean can be skewed, meaning it can look different than what it's really supposed to represent, by outliers, the observations that are really far away. Take a few minutes to write a short summary. Compare and contrast mean, median, mode, and range. Give an example for when you might need to use each measurement. See you in class.